Hello, this is Chiron Intuition, and I'm here to do a reading for the collective. It's not going to resonate with everyone, but if it does, take what goes, and please, leave what does not. We have the Hierophant out here first. So somebody could be part of some type of institution here. Somebody could have some type of title. We have the Ace of Pentacles. It looks like there's some type of new, like, financial opportunity, or there's some type of blessing that's coming in for this Hierophant, or this Hierophant is giving some type of blessing. Let me see. We have the Three of Cups. It's something about community, like bringing, this is that energy of like, when someone brings opportunity, someone brings jobs, someone brings, you know, food, for I don't know, like a community or something like that. But it's somebody that's very much looked up to. It's like they're bringing something to this community. They're bringing something very valuable. They're bringing an opportunity. Or it doesn't have to be community. It could be family. But whatever it is, it's a gift. Okay. We have the Six of Swords here. So it looks like this is the answer to something. Like this Hierophant has the answer to something and they want to move forward with it. It could be that this Hierophant is going to give, like, whoever this is with a title, maybe they're going to give someone a job. Maybe they're going to give someone like some type of opportunity and they think that this is the answer. Okay, let me see. We have the Six of Cups. Okay. It looks like someone is going back to something familiar, or somebody's going towards someone familiar. Like someone from the past here. There's someone with a title that's offering somebody from the past, from like a community or an old community or... And we have the Nine of Wands here. Wow. Whoever this person is has been through a lot. It could be a person, like I said, community, family, or something like that. It's like someone has been through a lot. I think they would appreciate this gift. It's also giving me, like, you know, because somebody been through a lot, maybe they're a bit standoffish about it or something. And then you have the High Priestess here. I feel like there's somebody not speaking on something. Like, they feel something. Like, if I was looking at this reading and I'm like, okay, what does this High Priestess know, but they're hiding? It would feel something like this Nine of Wands here. It would feel like, because everything else, what is there to hide here? There's nothing else to hide other than this Nine of Wands. Maybe somebody feels like standoffish. Maybe somebody feels like, you know, they have their boundaries up, their guard up or something like that. It's like maybe they don't know how to feel about something. Like, I see somebody going back. I don't know if it's going back to family, going back to friend, going back to somebody here. And they're offering some type of new opportunity. All of the energies leading up to this are very positive. Okay, including the Six of Swords and the Six of Cups, Ace of Pentacles and the Three of Cups. All of it. Other than this Nine of Wands here. Like somebody's definitely feeling defensive. Or they're feeling like they've been through a lot. It's almost like I would tell someone, like, don't miss the blessing, because it seems to be a blessing from, it looks like someone from the past, like someone that is familiar, like this Hierophant, maybe has not always been the Hierophant. We also have Taurus energy here. Yeah, the World card. Somebody's closing something out. Or they close something out. Someone could have matured, or someone could have went into a profession. You have the Queen of Cups here. The Queen of Cups is kind of making me feel like this is the High Priestess here. Because the Queen of Cups is also very intuitive. Okay. And then what you have the Eight of Swords at the bottom. It's almost like somebody's not changing, or somebody didn't change and they had to close out a cycle. Or they closed out a cycle. Like maybe somebody. Okay. Did this Hierophant close out a cycle with this High Priestess or Queen of Cups, however? Like, did they close it out? Who closed this out? It's looking like the Hierophant, because it's right on top of the Hierophant. You have the Nine of Cups here. Yes, this would be a blessing. You have the Temperance card. It's almost like. Or this Hierophant could be, I think I said at the beginning, they could be taking an opportunity. But it's something here from the past. This opportunity is something from the past here. It's something familiar. But this is a blessing here, a major blessing. This opportunity put someone on their path here. It may have been they closed out something with this Queen of Cups energy in order to pursue this. You have the Wheel of Fortune here. Yeah, this is definitely destiny here. Whoever these people are, whoever this person is. But we have the Seven of Swords here. There's something here that is like hidden, or something like strategic going on with this shift. That's another interesting thing that the High Priestess maybe feels, but they can't see. You have the Two of Wands here with the Six of Swords. It could have been another option here, or it could have been another direction they could have went, but they chose to go this direction. But it's like, it's something about remaining quiet, or not saying it, or not telling people, or something like that. You have the Ace of Cups here. Yeah, someone is choosing to go towards love. Someone is choosing to go towards healing. You have the Nine of Wands again. Yes, it is somehow like connected to this Six of Cups. There's somebody from the past that is like, I don't know if they're standoffish, I don't know if they've been through hell, I don't know what happened. But it's like somebody's energy is like at the top. I don't know how to say it. Somebody's energy, like somebody's hot about this, or somebody's mad about this, or somebody feels some type of way about this. It's something in the past, though. It's as if somebody wants to go back to like a past love or something. And then we have the Five of Swords. Yeah, I don't think somebody's gonna go for this. Yeah, and I just seen the Ten of Wands also. I don't think somebody's gonna go for this. You have the Magician here. Okay, this could be an air sign. It looks like someone's gonna be defensive, like someone. It's the energy of someone like created a problem, or someone is like creating a blockage, a problem. You have the Six of Wands here with this High Priestess. So if I'm looking at it from the perspective of the High Priestess is about to keep moving forward. Okay? Whoever this Hierophant person is, it seems to be that they closed out some cycle with someone that, let's say, cared about them, or this could have been a water sign, someone that showed them love or something like that. It looks like they closed that out with this High Priestess, okay? And there's some type of blessing that it's like maybe they want to give you, or they want to help you do something, or they want to help you on your path or something like that. And it's like it would change everything, but it's like I feel like they would want you to be quiet about it. If I'm speaking to the High Priestess, and it's like I feel like somebody has looked at their options here and they want to heal something, but they feel like you're going to be very either like standoffish, or there's going to be some type of problem, or I don't know what happened in the past. But it's like, it's as if somebody's standoffish because they have created something with this Magician card here. It's like they've created something, and it's like, almost like they see you as defensive. They see you as like going to protect whatever this is that you have made, whatever it is that you have manifested. So it's like they feel like there's going to be a lot of a block up because someone is being acknowledged for something here. Now, if I'm looking at the Hierophant energy, they know, or that something closed out with this person. And it seems that this Hierophant always has some type of feeling towards this Queen of Cups or High Priestess. They have some type of feeling towards, they have some type of connection here. But it's like still something like closed out. It's like I feel like there's a person with a title or part of some type of institution that wants to connect back with a High Priestess, but they feel like the High Priestess is standoffish or won't be interested. It says material and spiritual prosperity. That's Six of Pentacles. That is a blessing. That's like something you've earned, something you continue to earn, something like when you are in the balance of give and take, and you are receiving and you're giving, and it's just like a beautiful time. Or this could, like I said, just be a blessing that you have earned. Didn't I say in like somewhere in this reading, like it's almost like don't miss this blessing? But I'm not telling nobody what to do, but it just, the way that it comes out here with this Nine of Cups and then Temperance energy, it's like, it's really good energy. Like it even has the cups here. Sagittarius energy here. Oh, but then you have temptation here. You have the devil card here. And this is damn falling right on top of this Ace of Pentacles here. It looks like if it was some type of money or something like that, it's more, I feel like an opportunity or like a contract or like some type of obligation. It will be a blessing, but it's some type of obligation. This is like, I can see now why the High Priestess would be standoffish about this, because it's like, it appears that somebody closed out this cycle and now they want to bring some type of blessing, but it comes with, like, how can I say? It comes with, like, intentions. It comes with something. It comes with some type of intentions, and it's like I said, I can see why the High Priestess is standoffish about this. It's like I feel like somebody want, like they want to come off like they want to share something. That's how they want to come off. Like maybe I'll share wealth, or maybe, you know, you scratch my back, I scratch yours kind of thing. And it's like, they closed out some type of cycle here. And then it says prosperity begins. It seems to me like it is some kind of contract. If you are into the contract, then you do your thing. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't know everybody's situation. I do know somebody does feel standoffish about this. Even though it seems to be a blessing, but it comes with something here, and that's why it's either a contract or some type of obligation. But like I said, if you don't mind that, like somebody wants harmony, somebody wants to like balance something out, somebody wants to heal something. Like this is what they want to do. It looks to me like somebody's already, you know, doing their thing. That's what it looks like with this Six of Wands. It looks like somebody's already doing their thing. I mean, I'm just saying, and that's why this High Priestess will be standoffish. But I don't know. I guess it depends on if this person comes in. Destiny at the bottom also. It's like it's looking like somebody's meant to sign some, I don't know who it's for. It says spiritual strength, and that's the Nine of Wands energy here. It's like, yeah, somebody is very strong, but it's also like that strength is hard to penetrate. It's like I feel like somebody's like they're trying to have their way by offering you something. Transformation here. That's the Death card. Scorpio energy. So it's like somebody got stronger or something like that, or you have patience here. That's what, that's the Temperance card again. I feel like somebody has like something about their spirituality has changed, or something has shifted, or they believe something, or it could have been that they watched something grow here. Like maybe they watched you change. What's this at the bottom? You got the World card here once again. Like the cycle was closed out. Just like the World card that's right here. the cycle is closed out here. Because I don't know. I don't know how I feel about the... I mean, like I said, if y'all are into the contract, maybe somebody didn't give you the contract before or something like that. Or maybe somebody didn't give you whatever this was. Because if this is from the past, it's something that already passed. It's something that's already been done and finished. But somebody wants to open it back up again. Like they want to go into another cycle or something like that. That's what it's looking like to me. We have Mother, Father, God. It's definitely connecting back to source. It says blessings and abundance. So your blessings come from God. Look, I can't tell nobody what to do, but I can only tell you what I see out here. And I see somebody that either you closed out the cycle or they closed out the cycle, and now they want this back. But it comes with some type of what I can't remember the word that I want to use, but it just comes with something. Like there's a catch, basically. So it's like you have every reason to be standoffish about this. And it's also something about like your manifestation or your manifestation power. Like it's something with spiritual strength and manifestation. And somebody does need to protect this. Somebody has every reason to be standoffish here. Look, I'm going to leave this one right here. If you like the way that I read, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you so much for your likes, shares, and subscribes. I truly appreciate it because it is how we get the messages out in order to elevate the collective. I love you guys, and I'll be back with another reading later. Bye.